they young want. Nigga ballin', putting numbers on the board. I'm just stacking up the money, stack it up, it's never gone. What she say?
What up, though? This your boy, Cino Javon. We back at you again. This is Meet Me on the Block, your host. Y'all know the vibes. We got a guest star, Trix, in the cut. We got your co-host, Mighty JR, in the cut. Y'all know the vibes. We got Brittany in the cut. Y'all know what it is, man. We appreciate y'all. We come at y'all Tuesdays and Saturdays. And today, you saw the title. We will be talking about the Jada and Will Smith drama. It's on all social media. It's blowing up. Did Jada cross the line again? She needs to be stopped. You're putting a whole red alert on her.
But red flag. Red flag.
Oh, yeah, I said red alert. Yeah, red flags. Y'all know
that. Flag on the play.
Let's get into it. Hold on. I tried to set the move. We do it again, but look, hold on. We ain't about to go like that. If y'all on Star, y'all know y'all watch that show, BMF. Everybody in the show watch BMF?
Yeah.
So y'all
I have I'm waiting to binge watch.
Hold up, bro. So y'all know if you watch BMF and you watch the recent episode, y'all know the trending song that's going on right now. I gotta play a little bit just to show love in Detroit. You feel me?
What's going on? Yeah, because I haven't watched it yet either.
I ain't gonna spoil it, but it's just a scene.
Please don't spoil it.
But it's gonna do technical difficulties on me. Oh my god. There we go. Trix know what I'm talking about. That's how Will is tonight.
I'm so out the loop.
Get that nigga alone.
You talking about Will? Will?
Will Smith. Yeah. After he heard that quote from Jada, that's the song you played.
Get that nigga alone,
bro. Yeah, we ain't gonna spoil it for you, Britt and JR. So when y'all watch it, y'all gonna understand what we're talking about. But all right, man, we back at it again. Did Jada cross the line? JR got the quote. He told me that people got Jada fucked up. He said, we miss, what'd you say? What was that
man,
word?
Man, what's your opinion on it? Do Jada need to be the stop?
Look, I'm not in a position, you know, to try to affect anybody's pockets and all, but fuck
it. How you feel about it?
She need to be stopped because I feel like every time Will comes up in her, Will comes up in her mental, she always got something negative to say. Regard that man.
So what was the negative thing that she said?
What I got for was the entanglement situation. Also, I got was that from the quote that I read, it showed that she said that he hasn't been satisfying her in the bed lately.
Is but that exactly what she said?
No, that's not what she said.
And does everybody know the backstory on it?
JR got the juice.
Yeah, I watched the Red Table Talk.
Okay. But y'all know,
watch the full thing.
Summarize what happened.
Summarized in the video from the video, from the red top.
Does everybody know what happened between her and this whole August Alsina situation? Do they understand what actually happened?
I watched that too.
Yeah, I watched that whole episode too.
Yes, sir, okay. Same man.
So basically, what was it 5 years ago? Her and August Alsina were supposedly in some sort of open relationship. Jada and Will are married. So it came out, they were in this open relationship and everybody had something to say about it. And it was just a lot. You know, I gotta definitely give my love to Will because he handled it with grace, but
he sure did.
Definitely.
You know.
Salute to Will.
He sure did. But she only started talking to August because he was sick. I mean, they was friends for a little bit, but him being sick didn't help. They got close, and then
her and Will were having problems already.
You said what?
And then her and Will were having problems already, right? Uh-huh. So her and August must have already been friends, and I think she basically healed him. She said she felt good, and it made her feel
needed
like,
woman.
That's important in somebody's life because she was actually able to help him like through whatever he was going through.
Fair.
From what I understand.
Okay.
So I'm gonna let y'all get into it, but I just want to give a little
my take on the shit is like they've been together for a long time. They got what? They got three kids and like a couple bonus kids, right? As they call it, bonus kid. And he's one of the most powerful actors on the face of the planet. You are literally a direct representation of him in that last name. Like you know what I'm saying? So that girl don't spill the beans on an entire relationship on Facebook Watch. And it's like, how are you gonna recover from that? But when it comes to regards to the relationship, it's like, that shit should have been, when it comes to a marriage, that shit needs to be, everything needs to be taken care of in the confines of the relationship, in the confines of your marriage. Going out and putting shit on social media and having a fucking Facebook Watch party about the shit is not how you want your kids to find out that you got an open marriage. Like, come on.
So you don't feel like they knew?
I mean, maybe they didn't. I mean, we would never know. We're never gonna know.
Yeah, but, I don't know.
I mean, who knows? The way they kids be, they probably did know. Yeah.
Seem like a pretty open family. Very like I feel like they speak candidly and they speak open and honestly about what's going on, but they do it with love. I don't feel like there was ever like any disrespect. You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely.
For me, on the outside looking in, I feel as though they family got a lot of communication that we don't see. So it's like, we can't really necessarily judge what they got going on because behind closed doors, it's definitely different.
Right.
We only see what we see. And the only reason we saw that is because Jada has a show.
Yeah, definitely. Podcast.
That's the only reason. She has a podcast and she speaks very honestly about things that I guess women like go through and I guess people in general really go through it. It's not always pretty, but the truth isn't always pretty.
Definitely not.
So, I don't know. Cena, what you about to share?
I need to know everybody's opinion, though. Like, how they feel about.
About, like, open relationships?
No. About the quote.
But you said.
Maybe if I hear
what
it.
What you sharing?
I'm sharing
your screen.
I'm not trying to share nothing, but something is messing up. Can y'all hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
I was saying for the quote, I was like, you said that we got the quote wrong, so I was trying to hear the real official quote, and then we could give out our real opinion to it.
Started off and said, it's hard, she said. We started this at a very young age, you know, 22 years old. So that's why the accountability part really hit for me, because think you expect your partner to know what you want in the bed based off love. A lot of people think just because you love somebody, they know what you want. But in actuality, it's just hard to, you know what I'm saying, know what your partner wants because the communication is off. It's kind of hard to talk about sex is what she really was saying. From that quote, everybody basically was saying like, oh, you know, Will Smith ain't fucking her right. It's just like, can't really say that's what she said.
Shallow.
She was talking in general, like for couples out there. You know what I'm saying? It is hard to talk about sex with your partner because it's like, damn, you don't know me by now. It's like, you should know how to please my body by now because we're saying we love each other, right? But fact of the matter is, if you're not communicating that to your partner, they will never know. You can't read minds.
Mm-hmm. But how do you expect to communicate with your partner when you already agreed that you're looking for somewhere else to satisfy those needs in an open relationship? That's what I said.
It was a mistake. Like, I don't feel like she.
No, they have like, they have an open relationship currently now. So it's not like the August Alcina was like.
Do we know that?
That would
that to be a fact?
We don't know, but that's what the source.
No.
That was the source was saying when she was saying with the August Alcina that they already established an open relationship. It's just during that time, Will didn't know what she had going on with August Alcina. That's what the problem.
I think Will came out and said that she ain't know what he had going on. So it's just like, we can't really necessarily say, oh, Jada was just fucking up the relationship. It's like they had a communication thing going on. Like they had an open relationship.
Wasn't August the first one to say something about the relationship? Yeah, and it kind of like put Jada in like a precarious situation to where she's like, okay, now I have to go get on here and like really explain like what's going on. Yeah, so you all kind of
it was like a post or something.
Yeah.
It was like an interview we did with God, it escapes me right now. But he did an interview and he basically brought it up, which turned into posts and people like basically putting their own spin on it. She has a platform to where she can speak on it. This is like, these are the type of topics she speaks on. It's not like she brought it up to the public and was like, listen, I don't fuck with this nigga Will. I was fucking August and ended up in an entanglement.
Hey man, y'all got my boy Will going out bad.
No, listen, listen. All I was saying is, if they was having an open relationship, that's all the information we know. We know that they had an open relationship during that time, if you call it Sheena, whatever. They've been married for so long. I'm looking like, how do y'all have this communication issue? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, because you're saying that they had a communication issue where, you know, we've been together.
For example, you and your girlfriend got perfect communication? Like, y'all talk about everything?
No, I'm saying right now, I mean, I ain't going to cap. I ain't perfect. But I keep it 100. So I expect the same energy. Now, right now, I believe we communicate everything because I don't like surprises. I keep it 100. Now, she could be withdrawing information, but I don't know. But as of right now, it looks like she's keeping everything 100. But still, we still in the early stages of our relationship. Will and Jada have been together for years. That's what I'm saying. They've been together for years.
But shit and changed, though.
But I'm saying,
like,
though.
They've been together, since they was like 22? It's like, you don't really like the same shit you like at 22 at like 50. You know what I'm saying?
But I'm saying like everybody been in a relationship, and if you have any type of sexual, like, you know, intercourse with your woman or your partner, y'all know when they not enjoying it, right? Like that's what I'm saying. Like, I'm kind of confused on.
They can be out there winning Oscars for all I know. I don't know.
I mean,
it's every day.
Yeah. You feel me? I mean, to be faking. A relationship and a marriage are two different things, bro. Like, Corey, you know, I was married. Shit. I was married for a grip. I was with her for a while. And things changed. Like, we was together since we was, what, like 13, 14? Like, I'm about to turn 24 this year. Like, things change. You are not the same person then. Yeah. So, when it comes to...
What do you feel like the difference is between a relationship and a marriage? Because all I see is like a title change. It's just like official. In the eyes of the law, you are a union. Right. But what changes about the relationship?
You become more restricted, right? In the way you move. So, and a lot of times you become more restricted in just who you are, because that person becomes so codependent on you for almost everything, depending on your situation, right? Becomes so codependent on you for a lot of things. It could be for, you know, for quality time, it could be for just touch, or it could be for just anything. And it causes you to have to change the way you move, i.e. like having friends. Like, I wouldn't be able to go kick it with Cino all the time because I got my obligations are back at the crib, you know? And embrace the relationship, you have the ability to be more free still, because you don't have that, like, really. And I think it's a mental thing, right? So like that legal binding document makes you feel like almost like you in prison. Like, you can't, you know, go out with your friends, have drinks. You married, you supposed to be on the streets like that, blah, blah, blah. Versus when you relationship, it's like, but hey, go out, have fun. Like, I know you're gonna come back. You know what I mean? It's just that mental comfort zone in a relationship versus in a marriage.
You feel like the title changes things? Like the,
hell yeah. Oh yeah.
The title put a mental bondage on your well-being?
Yeah, man, I was with her for shit almost 10 years. We just now separate, getting divorced. It definitely throw a kid in the mix, throw a child in the mix of that shit, even worse, you know?
Right. And I get that, because I mean, don't get me wrong, like, I've always been like the type of person who like wanted to be in a relationship, but like there reached a certain time in my life where I felt the same energy. It was like an energy change. Like, as soon as you put a title on it, it's like all of a sudden now you possess me. You know what I mean? And that always kind of made me uncomfortable. because I really don't feel like it should change just because you slap a title on it. It should be exactly what it was from the jump, you know?
Yep.
You just, okay, now in everybody's eyes, you guys are just like boyfriend and girlfriend, or you're married. Like, but the people that people don't, I don't feel like that the title changes you. Like, my name could be Tara tomorrow, and I'm still going to be the same person Brittany is today. It's, that's just a name. It's literally just a name.
I think it's like, because I had a girl in the past where we was talking, and she kept her 100 with me because I actually ended it. But when we was talking, she was saying it was weird because it's like when we was talking, I didn't have to text her. I didn't have to see her. It was cool. If I didn't talk to her or see her again, she would have been straight. And everybody been like, oh, yeah, y'all were just talking. Y'all just flinging. She said, we in relationship. And then when I actually leave, that's when you got a lot of people judging that. They're like, oh, that's your boyfriend. That's supposed to be yours. He at the club. He doing this. Mm-hmm. But that's yours, though. But it's like, if we talking stage, I can be at the club dancing with other women. But they'll be like, oh, that's not your man, though. That's not your actual boyfriend. Like, he can do that. He just out there. But it's like, once you say that's mine, it's like, now everything what they do is like falls on your, like, on your head. So they're like, oh, that's your girl. She out there dancing in the mud, dancing with anybody else. And she's out there. She ain't showing no respect. So now you're starting to get that backlash. And I think
that's his business.
Yeah. That's what I feel like. It's like a brand. Like, especially when you marry, it's like y'all, that's a brand. That's y'all brand. Y'all have the same name. Everything y'all do for go show off the next person. Whatever I do reflects you. And I feel like once they get that title, that's when it gets to a certain level of, like, you know, it feel like you are stuck. Like, you're like, dang, I can't really go to the club this much because such and such may know my wife. She may think something different. She's like, oh, that's her husband. He out there drinking like that. He supposed to be at church. I saw him at church. So now it's showing on her, like, oh, your husband be out there going
crazy.
But
you see how that's somebody else's opinion about your relationship?
Mm-hmm. Like I said, it's society, yo. It's society.
That's what everybody doing with the Will and Jada Smith right now. How everybody bashing her because, you know, what we thought she said instead of like what we, you know, what she doing, they're like, oh, she's a terrible wife. She doing that to Will, you know, she always bashing Will. And, you know, and it's like, you know, Will's hearing all that. So that's how I look
at it. That's the thing, though. She didn't even say they was having bad sex. She was just saying on a journey, they just learning how to communicate. You know what I'm saying? Which you have to do. Communication is key all around the board.
Right. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, it is. That's definitely huge in a relationship. Definitely. Because if you ain't got that, you ain't got shit.
You are going to feel like you're in a prison if you feel like you can't communicate how you're feeling with your partner. Because at the end of the day, it is a partnership.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, like, I'm supposed to support your growth the same way you support my growth. Like, I'm not a perfect person. Nobody in here is a perfect person. So it's like going into that, you can't just expect, oh, all of a sudden we're married. You know what I'm saying? We went to the altar. We have these matching rings or whatever. And you can't expect it to just be like, okay, now you're perfect. Let me see what you got. Like, that's not reality. And that's just not real.
Yeah, it's not. Especially if you're doing it so young, yo. Like, you're doing it from 22s to teens. Like, all that communication, all that growth changes so frequently. So, like, in a blink of an eye, the person can get different, just like that, you know? And that's more or less just what happens in a lot of situations. Like, people just, they just change. Like you said, if you're going to support their growth or not. But a lot of people, instead of, like, not being submissive, but just kind of, like, understanding different people's growth. Like, don't be mad because they're going in this direction. You don't like that. It's not where you want y'all to go. If that person wants to go that way, let them go. Support them. Do their thing. If they want to take you with them, you know, that's cool. You may be going a different direction, but you guys got to be healthy with the shit. Talk about the shit. Make sure y'all on the same page as much as possible. It's okay to agree to disagree. You know, you don't have to be 100% on everything. And I think that's a lot of the misconception now with relationships, that y'all got to read each other's motherfucking minds. You got a motherfucking... know each other draws inside out, like, no.
And really, that's like a fast food relationship. Like, oh, I ordered my burger 2 minutes ago and now I expect it to be done and ready and perfect by the time I get it. Like, it's really like, you got to understand, like, if you're in a relationship, you can't look at it like, okay, how things are today or how things are going to be in 10 years. Like, you really have to, like, back away from the situation and see the big picture. if you support somebody's growth, whether or not that necessarily caters to your insecurities or not, that's something you got to figure out. But it's just like, whether or not it's comfortable in that moment, you have to understand that that person has to go through that anyways, with or without you. So if you really love that person, you're going to support, no matter how uncomfortable it is, you're going to support that person. But I think it boils down to like maturity and just like, you know.
Yeah.
I say another word that people should take in mind in relationships and even in marriage is the word of compromise. Because I feel like you got to be willing to compromise and go uncomfortable to, like, you know, to have a successful relationship. I actually learned that word in this relationship. Because it's like every time you meet somebody, you know, you go to your honeymoon phase, it's supposed to be like this forever. But the more longer when you with somebody, you know, you learn them every single day. So that probably is what the Will and Jada Smith.
And like the longer you with somebody, the less you become vulnerable. You get comfortable.
Yeah, get comfortable.
Vulnerability brings out a lot of emotion.
Yeah, then when you actually with somebody for about like 10 years, 8 years, 5 years, you be like, oh, I can say this or I can do this. They ain't going nowhere.
Cause maybe not even, bro. Not even that, bro. Sometimes it's like you got to walk on eggshells because they don't understand how to receive your messages. You could be saying something coming from your heart, but they could take it the complete wrong way because they're not mature enough to see what you're saying, to understand, to comprehend where you're coming from, to see that you want growth and you want that health for y'all, but they may not be able to see that. And that's okay too, though. But that's where you gotta, you know, like you said, compromise, right?
Right. Yeah. You know? Like, so if put yourself in this situation, y'all had a partner, y'all in an open relationship, open marriage, how would y'all feel? Can y'all stay in a relationship when your partner bashes you every moment she gets, where it could look like it's negative towards you?
I mean, there's criticism and then there's like constructive criticism. There's a way to present how you feel without bashing the person you feel like is hurting you or triggering these things inside of you. And I feel like it's really ego at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
You also got to be able to communicate to your partner. Like, if you're not telling your partner, like, hey, what you saying is hurting me, or the way you saying is hurting me, can you, like, say it a different way? That's really on you. Like, you don't really care that much about yourself if you can't tell your partner how you really feel. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you really got to communicate, bro.
I would just want to point out too, because the only thing I have an issue with Jada, and this is the only thing, it seems like she's venting all her problems on the red table talk. Whatever she's going through, lack of communication.
I mean,
and it feels like
the topic though. It's the topic was about sex.
It is, but I'm saying,
and then like the guest star they had on there was somebody who wrote books and like she helped couples be able to communicate how they want to be pleased in the bed, bro. It's about pleasure, you know what I'm saying? But it's just like her sharing her personal, you know, experiences, because you can't really talk about all this stuff unless you experienced it or you seen it or you did research on it, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like she doing what she knows. She's talking about it. It's the red table talk, you know what I'm saying? You can't really blame her.
No, I don't blame her. I'm just saying the only problem I have is when a lot of people, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, that could be, we don't know. You know what I'm saying? It's not like facts, but we don't know if that was Will's first time hearing, like, she's like not, you know, satisfied in that category.
Yeah.
Not saying a lot of people do that where they use a platform to actually express their inner feelings instead of their talking to their partner.
One thing was, she didn't even say she had a problem, though.
I really feel like, just based on like how they move and how Will is moving, like, Will could have anybody he probably wanted. You know, I definitely feel like, this is just my opinion, obviously, I'm not in the bedroom with them, I'm not in the house with them, I don't see what goes on. But just based on how he treats her, even though it seems to us like this is her first time coming out talking about these things, I really feel like they have these conversations prior to her going on the red table talk. That's like you going, like, that's basically like, okay, you going on Twitter. You know, we see it every day, like people going on Twitter, venting about their relationship. And sometimes it'd be the first time that their partner is even seeing that type of communication or seeing that they're upset. I really, in my heart of hearts, I don't think that the things that she brings up on the Red Table Talk are his first time. I don't think it's his first time hearing it, respectfully.
My thing is everybody want to really say like, will the victim, but it's like, if he not saying nothing, you got to realize he not saying something for a reason. It's like, oh, they already talked about it. I knew you was going to go on there and talk about it. It's just like, it don't affect me. We already on this journey to fix every problem we got going on anyway. They still married for a reason. You know what I'm saying? If he really had a problem, it'd have been adios. I don't care about no cheaper to keep her or whatever the case.
I mean, if
they really had a problem, they wouldn't be together.
Do you think? I mean, it could be a convenience thing, though. It could be a convenience thing. Just to, like, what's the point of breaking up at this point? They both, you know, getting older. They both got their money. They got their kids. It's like the most logical thing for them to do in this is to have an open marriage. Like,
there's an open everything. I'm saying, like, because some people actually, like, you look at the Brad Pitt and, you know, in his past marriage, what's her name?
Angelina Jolie.
Yeah, you know how they had issues, but they stayed together because of the kids. So, like, you know, that's what I'm saying. People, sometimes people stay in marriages for financial security, family. You know what I'm saying? I just look at it.
Kids like, are grown.
Oh, yeah.
Not very intelligent.
Are you talking
Will Smith? Not staying together for the kid.
They're not staying together for the kid?
No. Like I said, it's a convenience thing,
I really feel like they love each other and they respect each other.
No cap.
It's not something you see every day, but like respectfully, we as the public, we don't know. We're literally just judging based on what we see. If we were with them every day, we'd probably have completely different opinions about their relationship.
Oh yeah, most definitely. See, the only thing I will say this, and I don't judge anybody that's had an open relationship. Like, I'm always down to do whatever you want to do. You're your own person, whatever makes you happy, I'll go for it. I just feel personally, I couldn't do that just because I feel like if I made a deep connection with you, I like can't see myself with somebody else. I'm the type of person that can't do any sexual activity with someone else and still coming to see you in the morning. Like that just don't operate like that.
And I don't think an open relationship is necessarily just always sexual. I feel like it's, you want to go on a date with somebody? Go ahead. You know what I'm saying? If you want to have an intellectual contact with that person, go ahead. You know what I'm saying? It ain't always got to be sexual.
But wait, wouldn't that be considered a friendship?
Wouldn't it be considered cheating in a lot of people?
Exactly. A lot of people consider that cheating. Are you going to go on a date with somebody? I thought you was my man.
You said if it's not sexual, so I like, if I'm not trying to get any sex. So if
you
activity,
kiss a female,
that's sexual.
It ain't always got to be. You can kiss her on the cheek. That ain't sexual.
We ain't in friends.
It's definitely intimate.
We ain't in friends.
It doesn't necessarily have to be sexual, but. I don't know.
I mean, intimacy ain't
always. I'm looking at, like, what's the difference?
Intimacy got a lot to do with the mental capacity.
I'm just saying, what's the difference between me going on a dinner date with a female best friend and you know we ain't doing nothing more than just having a dinner date? Like, how'd that be considered an open relationship, though? That's what I'm saying, like, an open relationship.
If I go to court a woman and I got a woman at home. That's you feel me? If I'm going to court another woman, I'm cheating.
I mean, wait, so you saying if you go to dinner with a female best friend, and then what? Like,
Jay said an open relationship don't have to be sexual.
Going on a date with my best friend, she paying for herself. If I'm going to court somebody else, I'm paying.
I'm saying, how is that an open? So, what's your definition of an open relationship?
Because I look at
an
open relationship, bro. If you do something that you would consider cheating in your relationship, that's open relationship.
So
if you go court another woman, you don't consider that cheating.
Communication is key. Communication is key. Court? So before you even get into a relationship with this person, they should already understand what you consider cheating. That's and vice versa. So if you cross those boundaries, then okay, yes, whatever it is they do, it could be going to lunch with a best friend. That could be considered cheating. But if they don't necessarily believe that that's cheating and that's just you having a friend, then respectfully, it's not cheating.
Yeah, you guys should already have those predetermined like boundaries, right? You shouldn't, if you're over there crip walking on the motherfucking line, you probably cheating. You know what I'm saying? Like, you probably cheating. But I don't think, like, you know, you're going to lunch with a female friend and, you know, I don't think that's an open relationship. That's just, you know, your friends.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'll say, all right, what in y'all definitions, and y'all can both, like, state what y'all feel, like, what is an open relationship mean to you? Like, what are you expecting?
When y'all are both okay fucking somebody else.
Exactly.
So that's your definition.
That's my definition. If you guys are both okay with fucking somebody else, that's an open relationship.
Britt, what's your definition of open relationship?
Of an open relationship, I definitely feel like if you're being intimate with someone, meaning for me personally, like if you're having sex with somebody else, if you're doing anything like that with somebody else, then to me that's cheating. Like, just because that's something I'm not comfortable with, some people are comfortable with it. Like, okay, if you want to go have sex with somebody, cool. Or if you want to have a threesome, cool. That's not necessarily something that I'm yet capable of, you know what I'm saying, being okay with. I don't feel like it's something I probably ever will, because there's got to be a difference. What's the difference? Like, if you having sex over here and then having sex with me, we might as well be in a polygamous relationship.
Yeah,
that's how I, like, look at it. That's
personally,
what I'm
personally.
Like, that's how I look at it, because I said, like, if you in an open relationship, and that's why I was saying, goes all to the point where people are saying, like, and I'm not even just pointing at Jada, you know what I'm saying? Everybody got their issues. But I'm just saying, overall, people are like, oh, I have communications issues with my wife. I got communications with my man. I don't know how to do this, do that. And I feel like if you're in an open relationship, it's like you're furthering distance between each other. Like, y'all not trying to, like, work it out, because because you're hiding something and you're going, because, like, what happened, I'm in a relationship right now and me and my girl lack communication. We can't communicate, but we have an open relationship. So we're, instead of us working on our communication, I'm finding someone who could give me what I want from her instead of my girlfriend. So it's like, I'm running to that.
My thing is,
that's why I'm saying,
if you lack communication, you're not gonna have an open relationship. You gotta have communication to have an open relationship.
Yeah,
there's no way. There's no way in the world.
But wait, go talk to her.
No, but wait, look,
because she just said, you said Jada said a whole, she used her personal smear saying how you could be in a relationship with somebody and still that person don't know how to satisfy your body. That's communication. Cause I'm like, I can't satisfy you. So if we have an open relationship, if I'm not satisfied,
she never said that though.
No, you were just saying, like, you were saying an example. You said it earlier. You were saying that she's, like, speaking my personal experience.
I'm saying she never said he couldn't satisify her.
So what was the quote?
She said they were on a journey together, and it's kind of hard to communicate, you know what I'm saying, that what type of stuff you like now, you know what I'm saying? They've been together so long. You can't really just necessarily say you like the same. If you're 22, you might like trains ran on you. But you turn 30, it's like, all right, I don't like that no more. You got to be able to communicate, you know what I'm saying, what you want.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, though.
Give that person a chance to, like, understand your boundaries and respect them, basically.
That's what I'm saying. Like, so I'm saying, if they have those issues, not saying they do, we don't know, but I'm saying, if she's having, using an example, if she's having those issues and you're in an open relationship, is not going to get resolved, because whatever you're needing from your husband or wife to do, you're finding it somewhere else. Yeah. So you're running to that. So, like I say, let's say I like a girl to take control in the bedroom and my wife is not satisfying me in that aspect, I'm going to another girl that does take control of me in the bedroom. So I'm not complaining about it. So I'm like, oh, if I need that, I could get it from her. I don't need it from my wife. But I'm not trying to resolve
that. What I'm saying is if you got an open relationship, you got communication like that. You're going to tell your girl before you go to somebody else. If she's not doing it, you know, you don't always go look for that. You know what I'm saying? If you don't tell your partner, I would rather my partner do it than somebody on the street. You know what I'm saying? My part,
me and my partner got something going on. We got a connection. We got real intimacy going on. I'm not just going to go in the street like, oh, baby girl, you know how to take control of me? Come do that. You know
and
what
that's
I'm saying?
Cheating no, but, because you cheat in the process. You're cheating the process.
That's what I'm saying.
You're taking shortcuts and versus talking to your partner.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. JR is right. He said that's communication. You have to communicate. But I'm saying is if you do communicate, you first initiate the problem with your partner and they're not resolving it. So instead of you figuring out what to do at that moment, you're going to find solutions somewhere else. So that shows, and that showed that anytime you have a problem with a partner, y'all already have a system in place where, all right, if you're not trying to work or do stuff that I like to do, then we already agree that anything I need satisfied, I could get for somewhere else. And you're cool with that. So that's
I think that's the definition of all open relationships.
Not all. I'm just saying example. I'm just using that example. Just saying like I feel like you
shit,
can
if
communicate.
That's what y'all doing. Yeah, you agree, like, then okay, so be it. Like you know, but if you didn't agree to that, and now
yeah,
you just
we got problems
over mm-hmm. here getting what you need, getting your rocks off how you need to get them off, and you're not working with the person that you with, then you're not in an open relationship. You're cheating at that point.
Yeah, but all right. So here's a question for everybody right here. What would keep y'all from cheating on your significant other, right? Besides, let's just throw loyalty out, right? Because obviously loyalty would be faithfulness. Outside of all those things, right? What's gonna keep you home versus in the streets?
Respect.
The need to grow,
the longing to grow as a person, as an individual, because I'm not gonna cap, like I've cheated before. I 100%, and I look back on it like, damn, like that was just, it was weak in my opinion on my part. So it's like, mm-hmm. being the person that I am, I'm going to challenge myself to not do that and find any way I can to avoid doing that. And if it's right. If it's not something I can avoid, I'm just not going to be with that person. But
right,
you know what I mean, it definitely takes like a longing to grow as a person, as an individual. You feel me? You came in this world by yourself, you're going to leave by yourself,
right?
So it's kind of like, well, what do you want for you?
I look at it like, I say time. I my biggest pet peeve is time wasted. Like I could have been out in the streets, I could have have fun. I didn't want that. I wanted to build something with you. So I like, and I know, and this goes back to our last episode, JR, I think you remember when we was talking about that lucky lottery ticket. Like being the main nigga ain't gonna always be like roses. Like it's a gamble. Same way you gamble on the lottery ticket, same way you gamble with a job. You hope to get that promotion one day. You gonna have some heartbreaks. So it's like at the end of the day, once you get that lucky strike, you're going to be king of the world. You're going to have that greatest feeling. So that's why I look at it like every relationship ain't going to be easy. You know, we going to have times where I want to go walk out the door, but that time being wasted is what would bring me home. Because I'm like, I could have let you on that first date. I could have let you after that week, that month. I could have talked to somebody else because everybody got options. But for some reason, you want me to stay home and you are my home type shit.
Now, my question for you is, do you think it's time wasted or a lesson learned?
For what part? Like, what do
you
mean?
You were just saying your biggest pet peeve is time wasted. It's like you were saying we were trying to build something, but you know what I'm saying? Now we ain't got that. But am I saying, you saying it's time wasted? I'm saying, is it time wasted or is it a lesson learned? You learn something from that person.
You learn stuff from every relationship. Everybody's different. You know what I'm saying? But I look at it, you remember we talked about last episode, I look at it as blessings. Because at the end of the day, I look at it as like God is removing the negative part out of your life. That just wasn't for you. He saved you those years, like Tris was talking about, like how you go 10 years with somebody. And then, you know, at the end of the line, it's just like when y'all not compatible no more, you're not compatible no more. Now look at it. If you're blessed to see it early, that just like God saving you that time. Yep. That's what you know what I'm saying?
So what do you feel like a lucky strike is? Like for men, what do you feel like a lucky strike is?
Because
you say you don't
lucky
want
strike to stay faithful or to cheat.
What, like, what is a lucky strike to stay, like, faithful?
What's your winning lottery team?
So for me, it's a quality, right? Like, I look at it like this. After my whole shenanigans, my marriage and all this shit, bro, I look at relationships so fucking different, bro. So different. And it made me grow up a lot. So it's like things I can't buy, right? So look at it like, it's the easy way I can explain it. I could find a woman to clean my house. That's a maid. I could find a woman to buy me a house. That's a realtor, right? I need an asset for me that I cannot purchase out of my own pocket, right? I need something that is irreplaceable, right? You got to bring something to the table that I can't live without.
So what is an invaluable quality for you? Or give me like three.
It would be, and I can't even say understanding because you can have a therapist, right? So it's like, but I mean, you know what? In a woman, I would have to say for me, it's total
loyalty, respect, understanding.
It's loyalty, but to the point where it's like, and yeah, definitely respect, but understanding, right? It's just understanding me. It's understanding like my good days, my bad days, but not holding the words that I say to you against me, you know? But it's just like, you're going to go through shit with everybody. It doesn't matter who you are, what you're doing, whatever, right? It's who you want to go through the shit with. You're going to grow, you're going to change, that we talked about. But like, when you bring something to the table that I can't live without, like a connection. That when I first meet you, like, it's just off the rip, right? And a lot of people don't experience that. Luckily, I have after this whole shit. I met somebody that I would never, ever, ever even think about hurting. And it's the connection off the rip where it was just like, I knew what she was thinking. She knew what I was thinking. That's just like some shit in a fucking movie, bro. Like, it was insane.
It's poetry. And it was soul tie.
Yeah, it was a soul tie. She was like a twin flame, a soulmate, whatever you want to call it. It was beautiful. And it's still beautiful to this day. And she brought so much growth to me. She showed me who I was in a man. And that's what it was right there. She showed me when I was at my lowest of this whole situation going on about what type of man I am, bringing me closer to God and just like, tell me that I'm not my mistakes. Because everybody cheats, right? I'm guilty of it, right? But, you know, she brought me up when I was at my lowest. So that means if you can love me at my lowest like that, you can love me at my fucking best. And you deserve to be at the top with me. You know what I'm saying? Man, and a lot of women.
Talk your shit.
And there's a lot of women out there that just, you know, they want to be there when you get there. They don't want to follow you all the way up. They're men too, you know? But it's sexist because there's a lot of women at the top who don't fuck with niggas at the bottom. We got to be right there with you. And I think that's just fucked up too, but that's a different conversation. But you know what I'm saying? Like that type of quality, I need a connection that it's untethered. I can't touch it. I don't want nothing that's tangible. I want you to be in my head. I want you to be in my soul. I want to feel you. It was so tight, bro, to where I was walking in the hospital one day, cause that's where she worked. I could feel her. I felt her. And I turned around and she was like, I knew you was here. That shit blew my and I would never trade for the world, bro. She's the most beautiful woman I've met in my life, and I would never trade that girl for the world. That's the type of shit that I can't live with.
I gotta get
him back on the podcast.
Oh, yeah.
We gotta get him back on the block, man. I like that guy. Yeah. That guy talking some shit, man.
I can't even top that. Like, he killed me on that.
I ain't gonna lie, bro, but what, you know what I'm saying? You said understand, and me, my biggest thing is I just want to be appreciated, bro. Like, cause I'm trying my hardest, you know what I'm saying? And for a woman that can appreciate me for everything I'm doing, that's something that you cannot pay for. You know what I'm saying? That's just,
yeah.
That's a connection you can't find nowhere else.
Yeah. That's how I look. And I'm a relationship nigga. I always say that. Like, I ain't no side nigga. I ain't no player. I can't do it. But
still rather be a side.
No, but I'm just saying, like, what, like the girl I'm with now, like I was done. Like, people that knew me in the past, my past relationship, they did somebody for 2 years, you know, they had a child involved, and you know, and I just got treated like trash. And I just felt like you can give someone the world and they still would do you dirty. And I felt like I didn't want to be part of that. But she actually showed me different. Like Trish said, talk about how that connection. Just like that soul tie. Like, I just feel like she thinks, like, it's crazy because she will say something that I already was about to say. Like, we finish each other's sentence.
Stupid.
It's crazy. Like, we walked through the door, and we both said what we wanted to do at the exact same time. And then every time we said it, she'd be like, soul tie. And I feel like how you know someone is your lucky strike is when you want to like have the same feeling of like making your parents proud, like be making yourself proud, like you want to make them proud, like your partner, like you want to be like, hey, I did it. I did it for us, type stuff. And I feel like as a man, like you want to be the man in the house, but at the same time, it's like, oh, I want to do this for myself, but also I want to show her like she ain't got no squirrel. Like this is some king shit. Like this is for you. And I feel like once you got that energy, then she the one for real. Like you will know, like you will know if like if she said, hey, I gotta go a couple of days, or hey, like soon as she walk out the door, you calling her. Like you just saw her, but you calling her, you thinking about her. And I feel like if you don't have that energy where your girl could go a couple of days without talking to you, or your man could go a couple of days without talking to you, you don't care at all, then you like, that's not it. Like you gotta be like, I want you in my skin, Tyson.
Yeah, I want you in my space, your energy. Because that shit is intoxicating, bro. That shit is intoxicating as fuck. When you make that connection, it's like, it's nothing like going home and then let's just say you had a rough day, right? And it's not even just you want to bounce it off her. It's like you want to talk to her to see what she's gonna tell you, something different that you didn't hear before, right?
Yeah,
and that shit is sick, bro. It's like you don't even fuck everybody. I want to talk to my mom, I want to talk to my dad, I want to talk to you.
Talk to you, girl.
Tell me how fucked up. And it's the constructive criticism you get from that person that you don't take to heart, that you understand because it comes from love. You know what I'm saying? It comes from love. You ain't got to be a king and have all this money, but you can still be a king and just be full of love, bro. Like, and have a queen that's just full of love. Y'all don't have to have shit. Money ain't the thing to me. I don't give a fuck. But when it comes to love, bro, I'm not settling for shit. I settled for too long and I found my shit and I made it work. And I think everybody can, bro. Once you find shit, that like a fucking drug, keep taking
it's
that
addicting.
Shit.
It's addicting, bro. Like that was saying, like, I ain't gonna cap. I mean, I'll go put my personal business out there. Last episode, I got exposed. If y'all listen to it, she exposed me. It was all cool. But like everybody know in the past when I was dating girls, like if they say something like negative about me, I took it to heart. Like I'd be like, hey, don't come for me, whatever. But for her, it's different. Like she actually told me one day, she was like, bro, I had a whole interview. Like I was in a whole meeting, I'm talking, whatever. It went well, by the way. But she sat me down. She was like, babe, she was like, I could see you going so high in life. Like it's about to be crazy. But I feel like you're illiterate sometimes. And then I was just like, damn, like where? But I didn't take it to heart because I know she was like, hey, like, focus on that and then you go be 10 times better type shit. And I'm like, bet, for sure. So it's like, it's just that motivation that you got that partner with you that's like, hey, you at your lowest, but you teach each other different things together. Like it's never like she's primary, you primary. It's like 50-50. Yeah. Like, cause you better at stuff that she's not good at and she better at stuff that you're not good at, but y'all working together at the same time.
I wouldn't even say 50-50, bro. I don't agree with that shit. It has to be 100-100. Cause at least 100-100. If you lacking and you at 20, I can make up that extra 20. That you at 80, I can make up that 20% every time. But if you at 50, you know what I'm saying? That makes room for error. That's cheating. That's emotional cheating. That's a whole bunch of other shit. You know what I'm saying? And that's a door. That's Pandora's box. You don't want the motherfucker open at all. Mm-hmm. At all.
Nah, but so Britt, what would you say in your experience? What would make you? What's your lottery ticket? What is the like? What are you looking for? Like, what would you know? Like, oh, I can't leave this person. Like, they off of me.
Me?
Yeah, yo, you Brittany, you on the, you the only one on the podcast, Britt.
You the only one that ain't asked.
Mm-hmm. And she asked the question.
Right.
I be doing that though.
You do that. You all like,
I just
put
get lost
seat.
In y'all answers. Like, yeah, okay, because you teaching me something now. I don't necessarily, you know, think about. So I think it's cool. But personally, first and foremost, I'm like very big on honesty. So it's like my journey hasn't necessarily been like the prettiest, you know what I mean? So I think it definitely for me is just like somebody who understands and like doesn't judge me for like the things that I've done, mm-hmm. and just like sees the person that I am today, mm-hmm. and appreciates that and is motivated by that. And equally, like I want to feel motivated by that person. Like, I want to feel motivated to be better, to challenge myself in new ways. And I just, you know, I want to feel like that type of connection. So that's really big for me.
Yeah, for sure, for sure, for sure. Do y'all think that being wanted, would you rather be wanted or needed? And do you think one is toxic, more toxic than the other one?
I'm going to answer first because, yeah.
Go ahead, go ahead.
I feel like I would rather, like, okay.
Yeah, to think about it, she was like,
I thought we were there, like, shit.
And I hate giving this answer. I really, not that I hate giving this answer, but it's real. I don't feel like it's one or the other. I do feel like being like needed is cool. I can do that. But if you're codependent on me, like, that can be kind of stressful and it can be kind of toxic sometimes. Yep. So, I mean, of course, being wanted, like who doesn't want to feel wanted? You know what mm-hmm. I mean? Like, but like that, the needing aspect or the needy aspect of it, you know, I think it just depends on how the person is like manifesting that they need me, you know, like if it turns toxic, because like I've been in a situation where it's like the person basically needed me in their space. And if I wasn't in their space, they were like suicidal, you know, and that put them.
I've been there. Yeah.
Yeah. And it put a lot of pressure, on me because I'm like, damn, I need to be there for that person. I need to be there for that person. But it's just mm-hmm. like, can you need that person too?
Damn.
You know what I mean? Like, are you leaving me room to need you? Because I don't know everything and I'm not I'm not perfect. I'm going to need you sometimes too. So I just need to know that that person is strong enough to guide me in those times when I need them.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely both, but I disagree and I can't do the toxic neediness. I can't.
Gotcha.
What you got, JR?
Yeah. That boy quiet. That boy.
I had to rethink my answer for a minute. See me? I want both, for real. I don't know if that could be an answer, but I really need both. Like, I need you to need me spiritually, emotionally. I need, you know what I'm saying, that need part. I don't need that, like, that financial need or that, like she said, codependent part. Like, and then I also want to be wanted. You know what I'm saying? If I'm wanted, it's like, damn, you valuable. Like, you value me over a bunch of dudes who's been hitting on you or been in your DMs or been trying to get your number to gas. This, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's like when you feel wanted, it's like, okay, you really value me. Like, I got something to offer to you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So for me, it's really both. I don't know. I hate being impartial, but it's both.
It's where you at. It's where you at. So I ain't sweating it. What you got, you know?
Oh, dang, I thought I was excluded on this one, but all right. I say I gotta be with dang, my stuff blurry. Hold on, focus. There we go. But I gotta go with want because I feel like if you want me, then you're gonna work with me. You're not gonna let it go, but work, but each category I have its own toxic trait to it. One can mean like I can never let you go. Maybe I don't want you no more, but I can't live without you. Which goes with Brittany example. Need is like you needing me, but you need me to benefit you. You don't want me. You didn't need me because I could put you in a better spot. So it's like I would say I have both, but I'd rather my main trait would have be want, because if you want me and I want you, we good. We gonna work it through with it regardless. But same time it still has this toxic in it.
Yeah, I feel that. I would choose want, period. Needing somebody, that shit's crippling as fuck. Because how you gonna function if you need somebody? That means you can't even stand on your own 2 feet. You can't mentally be strong enough for yourself, like you were saying, suicidal. I went through that shit where somebody needed me so much they were trying to kill themselves. And then, but being wanted, that shit is, I think to me, you choosing to use your own free will and you desire somebody, and when you know that you're mentally strong enough, you're healthy enough to be able to want somebody in a healthy way, that shit is a fucking, that shit out of this world, bro. That shit's crazy.
Yeah.
Super healthy.
All right. Let me think, though. I'm about to get y'all. I'm trying to think of a good question. I'm trying to get Britt, bro, because Britt came for me, bro. I'm trying to think. What's the
good one? What happened?
Man, I was watching this podcast with Kevin Gates on. He was saying that he prayed before sex. How y'all feel about that?
Wait, what?
He said he prayed before sex because it's a spiritual thing. How y'all feel about it?
I like it. But at the same time, this is not my quote. This is like my grandma quote. She only have a problem. I like it though. I don't like condemn anybody that prays. You know what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. But my grandma always told me, if you ain't married, theoretically it's a sin. So my grandma would say, how you gonna pray the Lord to protect you from for any reason during sex, but you're sinning at the same time? It's like she'll say, like, hey Lord, I'm about to go rob this bank. Please help me get this robbery good, but I'm stealing. You feel me? If something bad happens, like, you're doing a sin. Like, I don't know. Like, but I definitely support Kevin Gates' prayer because I did it. You know, I was like, I ain't perfect, but I pray it all the time. I pray every time because I'm just paranoid. I'm a paranoid person. So
you do pray before sex?
Yeah. I pray.
I never even thought about to pray before sex, if I'm being honest. But praying with the right person. Before, just one person, not a bunch of them.
Just one.
I think that's
every time I'm about to get in the cooch, I'm about to get on my knees. No,
not every time. Yeah, like I'll talk about like if it's like the first like if you dating somebody and you like, cause God know your heart, like you know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't trying to be out there, like you actually like trying to be intimate with that one person. So I feel like the first time I pray, but after that, we good. You know what I'm saying? But the first time we doing it, oh yeah, I'm praying.
I feel what he was saying, though. It's more of a spiritual connection, you know what I'm saying? When you with that person, it got to be the right person, like you said, though. It got to be the right person. Yeah, it's just when you spiritually in that moment and you, like, y'all both just connected, intertwined together, it's just, like, it's a whole different feeling. It's a whole different, you know what I'm saying, orgasm, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Can we say orgasm, man?
We said we'll say it. I mean, we said pussy and everything on the show, so
that's politically correct.
Yeah, I like.
That's politically correct.
it's too late to be censored now, Jay. You better just go all out.
I want to know, like, how do you pray before sex? Like, I want to pray before sex. I want examples.
All right, y'all don't want to know my real answer, though, because
I've never done it before.
I know what I would say, but I've never done it.
I want to know what you would say, even if you haven't done it.
I would be like, you know, I pray for, like, the connection, the spiritual connection.
Which I like that.
I'd pray for just, like, the intimacy part of it. Like, I'm not just smashing. If I'm going to pray before sex, I'm making love to you. Every time, period.
Every time.
Oh, so y'all doing the good prayers.
Pledge.
But you praying for what? Pledge. STDs, right?
Yeah, I just asking the Lord. I said, Lord Jesus, please don't let me have no STD. Like, she cold. Like, please don't let it be nothing coming back to me.
So you praying after any little nut you get.
I'm praying for that
connection, that great soul tie.
I'm saying I'm praying for the STD, not for every person I'm smashing, because I'm a relationship nigga. So I'm praying the STD, to praying to God that this is the one for me. Please don't let her have no
STD. My dog bringing Jesus into what he said it was.
I'm praying for that. Like, I'll be like this, like, Jesus, you know how I feel about this person. She may be the GOAT. Please don't let her get nothing, bro. Please, okay. That's not playing for.
I think I'm gonna pray, if you don't mind. I think I'm gonna pray for a healthy connection, an honest connection, but definitely it's gonna be connection included. You know, and I'm just gonna pray that this is where I'm supposed to be, and if it's not, let me know.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me?
Your body will let you know.
This one's for you, Britt. Would you be with a man who, it's going to be a tough one. So you got to look, you kind of look past yourself, right? could you be with a man who has cheated on you, but is showing you consistency that he's gonna, I'm gonna say a boy slash guy, right? Who has cheated on you, showing you consistency that he's gonna change to become a man. Because I think the biggest misconception when it comes to dudes is that we come out, most men come out faithful. I mean, there's a lot of faithful dudes out there, right? But in order to become a man, you gotta go through some shit. Men become, i.e. you become a man, right? So do you think that you could be with a man in his process of becoming a man, his true self? Or do you think it hurt you too bad to where you had to take a step back, reassess situation, and probably leave?
Shit, I might have to take a step back, but if I come back and we're in that position, then I could definitely see myself being with someone who wants to grow and is showing and proving that he wants to grow 100%.
I think the biggest upset to females in that situation would be that he was better for somebody else instead of the one he was with, you know, that he hurt. He didn't put the effort in to make it better for you. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. We all make mistakes, though.
Right.
Like, you may have needed to go through that, you know what I'm saying, to see that your actions weren't true to who you want to become.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I definitely feel like that's okay. That's a part of the relationships. Like, boy, respectfully,
I go,
nobody's perfect. Like,
so look, my girlfriend, she has a rule, I guess. Like, she kept the 100. That's why I love her, because she keeps 100. She told me up front, she said, if you cheat, it's over. It ain't no chances, because she feels in her mind is that you willingly did something to hurt me. You disrespected me. And she feels like you can't come back from that. She's like, if you did it before, you do it again. I'll be honest. In the past, when we first started dating, I don't cheat, but I mean, I'll go see if y'all call it cheating. Y'all know I'm on TikTok. I'm TikTok famous regardless, right? So I never had that type of attention before where I'm getting, my DMs are getting flooded. It's on the Instagram. People find me on Snap. TikTok DMs is all like hundreds of comments. Women is like going crazy. I never had that before. So I'm talking to her. So I figured that I had to entertain my fans to keep their attention, to keep the likes coming in. So, you know, I would comment back, you know, I would say some things back. If they say I'm handsome, I'd be like, you fine, you gorgeous, you know. Woo-woo. But I was never trying to take them seriously. I was just doing it for business. Mm. She saw my phone and I actually gave it to her.
Boy.
Yeah, but I'm not saying they say that's cheating. But honestly,
I think where a lot of women go wrong is that they automatically, okay, a man cheats, right? You want a committed relationship. They know your boundaries. They know that's not something you're okay with, right? And then they do it anyways. My mother always taught me, like, you got to teach a man sometimes. So it may be hard to step away because you may love that person down. You know what I'm saying? And you know that's not really who they are. But in order for you to learn a lesson, you're going to have to be without me for a little bit. And that's why I answered the way I did and said, I may need to take a step back. You know what I'm saying? But as time goes on, you know what I'm saying? Give that person some time, some space to realize that they actually do care about you in the way that you thought that they did initially. You know what I'm saying? Give that person some time, some space to miss you. And then from there, it's going to let you know everything, in my opinion. Like, if I've done that and you crying on your knees, you begging, you sad, you know what I'm saying? Whatever.
Yeah.
Like, it's gonna, like, if I care about you, it's gonna hurt me too, but I know that we have to go through this in order for you to see. Because if I just jump back with you and be like, oh yeah, it's cool, it's fine, like, I understand you were going through that, they're gonna think that that's okay. They're gonna think that's okay. It's called enabling.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm not gonna do is enable someone to just, you know, feel like that's okay and like, oh, she's gonna be there regardless, I could fuck up and she's gonna be there. No, like, you're gonna have to be without me.
Yeah,
period. And then that's gonna let me know, like, what do they say, like, if it's meant for you, if it goes away and it never comes back, it was never meant for you. If it comes back, then
yeah, it was meant
to be. There's a chance.
Okay, okay. All right, so JR, you got some closing remarks. We are about to close soon. You've been quiet over there, bro.
I'm up over there.
I ain't been quiet. I've been talking, some shit, man.
That boy in the shadows, man. That boy
has been chilling, man. I'm
that boy is late.
That boy like this.
You want to got some closing remarks? So I got this quote from Kevin Gates. I wanted to know what y'all feel about Kevin it. Gates. Said, the way you fuck your woman in private is how she respects you in public. How do you feel about that?
Nah.
Wait, hold on.
Nah? So you, if you ain't laying it down.
If you laying it down, she gonna be acting like a saint in public.
That's what I'm saying.
No, you can't be laying it down, bro. You could be laying down the best dick, but if you could be, there could be other aspects. So you could be a disrespectful as fuck.
No, disrespectful. You gotta treat her like a gentleman. You gotta still open the doors.
Like you know like treat her like a real warrior. Yeah.
But you gotta. But if you laying it down and doing that.
Oh yeah. Okay, if you're doing it all. Yeah, because I'm thinking that you just talking about.
Wait, hold on.
Keep a woman, bro.
Wait, hold on.
It don't.
Yeah, I got a question.
How you feel about this?
Wait. Hold on. Before break, I do that, and I still got exposed and disrespected on the last episode. That's a bullshit,
you man. You lack of.
I need to go. I need
she
to go.
Ain't told you, yeah, you got to go talk to her, bro.
I will tell her. Y'all had a red table talk moment. That's all that was.
So, Bri, how you feel about this statement? You want me to read it again? I got you.
Yeah, go ahead.
The way you fuck your woman in private is how she respect you in public. Kevin Gates.
Wait, I have a curveball. What if you want to be... fuck like a slut, like.
But he doing that, and he's still opening the doors. He's still like, you know, what I'm saying? Yeah, he's a gentleman. But he putting that pipe down.
So he's doing everything he should be doing then.
Exactly.
Yeah, she should.
If he's doing everything he's supposed to be doing, then I will reciprocate. Period.
His actions would speak to her.
Okay. Look, I just posted this quote earlier, bro. I said, if you laying it down, your partner ain't gonna want you to leave. Like, they ain't sharing nothing. That's theirs. Right. They gonna have to answer. If you out there screwing around, that means your stuff ain't good to be cuffed.
But see that dick, though. You know, that dick. You know what I'm saying? He could be the most disrespectful ass person. You know what I'm saying? Behind closed doors, but he could lay that shit down. You gotta
put you in your place, huh?
That's that toxic.
Right.
That's that toxic.
You got very toxic.
She'd be like, I hate you. That baby boy.
But you fucking me like a dog.
I hate you, Jody.
Two seconds later, I love you.
No, you definitely. Wait.
Before we close, did anybody have toxic dig or toxic cooch?
Have we ever?
Definitely.
Yes.
Definitely.
And then what was y'all toxic situation that y'all remember? Like, how did you know personally that you like, oh, I'm screwed, bro? Like you knew it was toxic, but it kept drawing you back. Like, what was like your drawing back moment? Like, you couldn't leave. Like, you're like, dang, like, I gotta go back. Like, you know you hated it, but you gotta go back.
Let me say this. I got court cases pending, so I ain't about to I ain't about to do all that.
See, like,
I got a divorce going on in the back, so I ain't about to, you know what I'm saying?
T is excluded. JR, you ain't excluded.
Keep it going back?
Yeah.
Bro, I'm a nigga that like toxic shit. I ain't gonna lie.
Oh my god.
So if you keep it toxic and that shit wet, I'm there.
Brit.
Typical. I already know what she gonna say. All y'all niggas all the same.
Brit, what you got?
I mean, but he laying it down.
See, look at him. See, look, kill him. Go ahead, log off.
Have I been dickmatized before? Yes. Yes, I have. It was toxic as fuck. AF. Can I say that? I'm going to say AF. It was toxic, but I was just like, damn, that dick. God damn. Like, I'm going to put up with you. You know what I mean? I'm going to put up with you as long as I can put up with you, but god damn. Like.
All right. So Bert and JR went through it. Now, this is for the guys. This is a question for the guys. Have y'all ever been manhandled by a woman where it felt like you were just, like, you just felt like you wasn't a man in the bedroom?
Bro, I'm going to let you know now. I'm like 6'2". If you can manhandle me in the bedroom, girl.
I ain't going to lie. I'm 5'6", so I did get manhandled before. All right. I ain't got that.
Like we say hi. I'm 6'2" as well, bro. So like, I mean, I'm not opposed to her taking a little bit of charge. It's all right. It's kind of sexy when a girl kind of start maneuvering. You like, all right. You know what I'm saying?
So I'm not. Yeah, it is, but the thing is, bro, I'm a nigga that I really enjoy pleasing my partner. Mm-hmm. Like, it's a different feeling. Like, she can get all the orgasm in the world and I can never come. But me knowing that I did that?
Yeah.
Oh, girl.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's enough.
Like, you can't get JR.
Yeah, it's a mental thing.
It's a mental thing.
Like, I was watching a podcast with Kevin Gates on it. That semen retention shit he was talking about.
The what?
The semen retention. You ain't heard about that?
I think I know what you're talking about.
Isn't it semen retention November, C-note?
Like, no nut November? Like, that's the thing. But
well, I failed.
What he was talking about semen retention is, it's about pleasure. It ain't about coming, bro. It's about, like, pleasing your partner. Like, he talk a lot about eating ass. I don't eat ass.
Kevin,
I might in the future. Bro. But, you know what I'm saying? That's that. Fact of the matter is, if you know how to please your partner, it's a different, like, intimacy. It's just like it's a mental thing, bro. It ain't always about sex. It ain't always about coming. Yeah. And then all, you know what I'm saying? He was saying, like, if you feel yourself coming, just stop and it just heal your body. You know what I'm saying? I might be on that. I might start a challenge, man. A semen retention challenge, man. Put me on the books for that. I might start that. I'm gonna let y'all know how it goes.
No, he's speaking facts.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You gotta, bro, when you hear stuff like that, you gotta take notes. You gotta really hear what they're talking about. You can't, it sounds like bullshit, but I'm saying, think about it. When you release, it's like you get lazy. You get your energy gone.
That's bull crap, though. Because how women can have like 20 orgasms and still want to keep
it's going. Different for men, though.
I know, though. Like, that's bull crap, though. You know what I'm saying? They could be like, I want again. Like, you can't 20. This is my first time. Like, I'm just chill.
But when you pleasing a woman, bro, you can't, like, all the orgasm they get, it's just different, bro. It's a different mental thing.
So let's mess up the head real quick. Not every orgasm a dude has or nut, whatever you want to call it, is the same, bro.
Yeah.
It is not all the same. It's not all the same. It could be just like, it could be like, oh, but girls think once they talk, they good, right? But we'd be like, dang, that won't crap up to be like, you know what I'm saying?
You got the curl toes effect.
You got the turtle back. They be like that.
You got the hunchback. You got the turtle coat. You got the twisted toes effect.
You ain't gonna be quiet over there. What you got?
You
to
got
say
the
about
paralyzed it? Effect. You can't move. Look, Brit like this. Mm.
What you got to say about this?
This for the men.
No.
He said it was for the men. I'm quiet.
I'm saying, what you got to say about it?
What I gotta say?
We need the female perspective. That's the whole point. You hear? You gotta talk about it.
That's just the biggest misconception for women when it comes to dudes finishing. They think it's like, oh, they get off. That's it. Like, it's not all the same.
Nah.
Each finish.
You gotta. If I come, I can keep on going.
So can me. It's a whole connection thing.
Yeah. It's a connection. I think it is a connection thing.
And those red, blue
but pills. But women have a difference. We definitely have a difference.
Hey, no. All you need is liquor. I mean, I'm not promoting liquor, but I'm saying, if you drunk, you definitely could keep it going. Yeah, you could definitely get that whiskey dick. Hey, females, if you listening, you could definitely get that whiskey dick. That ain't excluded. But I'm saying, if you buzzed enough, he can make you come.
Well, do the brown liquor or the white liquor affect the bedroom?
It don't matter.
I don't do
it. Don't matter. I've been on both.
I don't do brown, though. I don't do brown.
Yeah. I've done both. I've been a douce nigga all my life.
What are you drinking and right now? But
I'm drinking. Hey, hold on.
That is the only clear shit I would drink.
Tito's, nigga. This is vodka. This is cheap vodka.
Y'all want to drink the Casamigos?
Casamigos.
Hey, that shit make me freaky as hell.
That's the only light liquor that I'm
drinking. That shit make me freaky as fuck.
Otherwise, it's brown for me.
All ladies that listen, if you in the D, get
that Reposado.
Get JR Casamigos. But all right, man, this was a great podcast. We talked about a lot of stuff on here. We hope that Trish hop on the podcast regularly. You know what I'm saying? How do you like on your first show?
Sure, man. I appreciate y'all having me, man. It was a good time.
Yes, sir.
It's good having you.
You got to come back on the block, man. I ain't trying to be a one-timer, man. You got to come back.
Just let me know, y'all. Y'all got my number. Y'all got my Instagram. Hit me up.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hey, let the viewers know what your Instagram is, man.
Oh, yeah. Vibing with TC, man. Hit me up. What's that? V. I don't know. That's my own Instagram name. V-I-B-I-N with TC, yo. Follow me.
Salute, man.
And Drake's social media will be in the link in the description, too. So if y'all couldn't catch that, it'll definitely be in there. But this will meet me on the block. We're coming at you every Tuesday, every Saturday. Stay tuned. Like, comment, subscribe, share, tell your friends, spread the word. We out here. We lit. Y'all be safe. See y'all on the next episode.
Yes, sir.
Oh, it won't clip. Oh, with that young nigga, I'm putting numbers on the board. I'm staying up the money, stack it up, it's never gone. What you say?